When I started here over 7 years ago, our graduation rate was among the lowest of any large urban. We had the highest expulsions, suspensions, citations. We were the poster child for every poor demographic data point.
Teenagers right now go through so many things that maybe I didn't in my youth.
I felt like if I don't get over a 90 or an 85, that's the end of the world. So I stopped eating and lost weight.
I was in a very dark place where I didn't want to go to school. I didn't want to make friends. I didn't want to do anything but just go home and go to sleep.
Just the struggles of being a high school student, going through puberty, you know, having friends, girlfriends, boyfriends, all that stuff. So they're under quite a bit of stress and they're not sleeping. They go to bed at like 3 a.m. and then wake up for school at 7, so.
Especially being in high school and you have 3,200 kids on campus, right? You might feel alone and isolated. You might not be able to find your niche.
And it begins to harden them. It creates a mindset of hopelessness. And you can't get kids on a trajectory for prosperity and high levels of success if you don't have a nice, strong foundation around the health and wellness of who they are as people.
We don't have the funders that other places have. Everything we do, it has to be collaborative in order to be able to not only pull the necessary funding together, but to make it sustainable over time.
So today we'll discuss how much sugar is in our favorite drinks. It's really different when you see it physically compared to when you see it just on a label.
What we do here is we collaborate with the staff and the students just to promote nutrition, physical fitness, mental resilience through a lot of different creative programming.
When we heard about this program with HealthCorps, it just made sense having a curriculum and the support structure that's necessary with a coordinator to lead not just the young people, but the entire community to a mindset around health.
With Stephanie coming in the room, she's just like this huge toolbox of what I'm using already, more tools than I possibly knew I could use.
What I've seen is a strong development of relationships with students to get them excited about health initiatives and then coordinate with the health career pathways. They're implementing cooking classes. They're coordinating with our gardening club.
Gardening for me definitely has a meditative side to it. It helps me calm down my brain and my thinking.
I didn't realize until I joined HealthCorps how much meditation could help me. I know that the students who do come here, they are happier when they're here, because after a stressful day at school, knowing that they have HealthCorps to come to, I know that it helps them a lot.
What really brought me to an interest in HealthCorps was the resiliency piece. The suicide rate is ridiculous now. And so having a place where they can get the tools to be able to deal with, address, manage those stresses is more critical than ever.
One thing I've learned from HealthCorps is definitely how to maintain mental health, but also like being able to talk to my family and friends about it.
Most teachers will ask me to do a lesson focused around stress. And just by talking about it and bringing it to light, where it's often a topic that's not talked about so often, and then giving them coping strategies to work with.
We're learning more and more about the struggles that our students have. If we cannot meet the mental health needs of our students, no academic goals are going to stick.
I think HealthCorps has got a very bright future because it's good politics and it's good policy. Kids need help, we're there to support them, policymakers, stakeholders, civic leaders, principals. Even the kids themselves recognize that we can play a role in bettering their lives.
We have seen some of our highest graduation rates at Sanjee High School, where HealthCorps is active. We have seen some of our highest attendance rates at Sanjee High School, where HealthCorps is initiated. Year after year after year, we've seen those indicators continue to improve and grow for our students.
HealthCorps is not only affecting me, but it's also affecting my other classmates and my close friend as well. From what I've learned from HealthCorps, I've changed what I eat and I've lost weight. And it's made me feel better.
Ms. Starks told me to start like eating healthy foods such as like peanut butter and like whole grains. I know I gained at least 5 pounds, which is like good for like a few months. So Ms. Starks reminded us that our grades don't define us, and then I took that into like mind, like, okay, my grades are not gonna be like the grades that define me for the rest of my life.
This just makes sense, and it's where we need to be. I think as school districts, I can't believe that more school districts aren't implementing this program.
Bringing this on your campus will change the climate and culture in a positive way if everyone's able to get on board. I promise if you do it, you'll see a change on your entire campus.
I see my friends being a lot more positive and talking about mental health. I would have not continued to go to school if it wasn't for HealthCorps.
I'll see notes from the students that say that they feel happier, that they're more confident, that their self-esteem has increased, that they feel like they can make healthier decisions and that they can live a better life as a result of this program. And that's what makes it worth it.